So we have come somewhere between Bhubaneswar and Cuttack, where they make apparently they make good rasgullas.
Move over, loser. Buy us. Don't trust a Bengali's version of rasgulla.
Hello everybody, this is the day 4th. Say hi. Are hi to bolo sab. Hi. So it's day 4th. Lalitgiri bhi hai gun ne.
Lalitgiri, Ratnagiri.
Lalitgiri, Ratnagiri. All the giris. Yeah, we are completing all the giris today, okay? So stay tuned.
We are climbing all the mountains.
Yes. So, and if you see, I am dressed up for the mountain. And my mobile is not working. So, laptop mein process karne ka, photo uthane ka. So, we have just arrived at the site of Lalitgiri. That's our bus in the back. And that is Lalitgiri entrance that we have. So, it's a diamond triangle. So, first we have reached Lalitgiri. We'll enter. And then, you see, that's the ticket counter out there. Let me show you the price of tickets out there. It's Indian visitors 25. Bimstek visitor, I'll explain to you what is it. It's addition of Myanmar and Thailand also. Foreign visitor 300, video ticket 25. Children below the age of 15 is free. Museum timing. Oh, there's a museum also. 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. 5 day is closed. Photography is strictly prohibited at the museum. But the sites, it's open. Okay. This is the entrance. We'll go somewhere out there. So this is the site of the Lalitgiri. I think that's the museum out there. We'll go up. But first, I think we need to see the museum. Some inscriptions out there. Let me copy them so that will be easy for me to refer.
What is written outside?
So this is Monastery 1. You can see the brickwork. Some pillars still remain. Nothing much. If you can climb this place or not. Monastery site 1. You can see some of those different structures, but not much remaining. This is the monastery site 4. And we can see one statue of Buddha, I think so, if I'm not mistaken. That's the altar out there, statue of Buddha. You can make one more something out there, but it's not so clear. These may be the different rooms. Beautiful. Let's move to the other side. Okay, so this is the Chaita Griha Stupa complex. For some reason my autofocus is giving some issues. So let me see how I can shoot in complete manual mode. It's not so difficult. I've shot previously, but since the time is short, it takes time to compose the shots. But what you get is excellent precision, which otherwise you would not get. Excellent. Wow. This is really good. You see all this? Beautiful, isn't it? Okay, now going towards the stupa, one of the main structures out here. See a lot of people out here. That is the precise reason I like to go separately so that I can take good shots. Stupa. Let's take a round of the stupa. Look the same all around, but this is the site 3, showing you the stupa out here. The altar is there, but the idol is missing. These are the various rooms. You can see there's still some remains. Beautiful, isn't it? It is beautiful because anything historical is beautiful, because that is our past. Perfect. Let me get some more shots. The best thing about autofocus not working is that you tend to use the manual ring a lot, and then gives you a practice. It becomes, makes you more quick in changing different settings. So it's good and bad. Got used to this mode. Let me climb to the top and get a good view. Side 3. Again back to Monastery 1 because I did not get this view. So taking. Okay, now going towards Monastery 2. Surprisingly, the one is up ahead out there, and 2 is on the right when you enter from there. That means if you come from the gate, first will be the monastery number 2 on your right, then up ahead will be monastery number 1, and then you had the school, the temples and the stupa and all that stuff. This place indeed looks like it's in completely ruins, because even the road ends out here. It's paved till there, not paved, means you have those brick road. This, I think they are still trying to recover something, because that's where they are mixing the lime too. Out here. But these stupid people, they have ruined it actually. I think this is a drainage system, some kind of that. Beautiful. And that's the view you get of the villages all around. Let me take a... Okay, so we have got down from our bus. The reason is this. It's very steep, it won't be able to climb because it's AC bus, it's heavy. It's hitting the axle, it has already scratched, so we cannot take risk. So the rest part of the journey, this is the road we are supposed to take. We will, what we are going to do is, there are 2 Innovas, they'll come shuttle and pick us up batch by batch. So keep watching, it's good that we get to see the rural village road. Let me take his photo. So we are waiting for the Innova to come back to pick us up. In the meantime, let us explore this part of the... Okay, the people stay out there. So we have reached that Toshali resort, and here at the Ratnagiri, and it's already around 3 in the afternoon, and we are yet to have our lunch. So not so sure we'll be able to complete the entire circuit, but let's head for lunch at the moment. And this is how we came in this auto, because again
it got stuck. There was some construction, so we could not go through. Yeah. Best of luck for us.
We have just entered Udaygiri, I think. Lalitgiri we have covered, now it's time for Udaygiri. Beautiful place. These are votive stupas from 18th to 11th century. This is the shrine complex. Oh, look at this side. This is gorgeous, man. It's too good. Let me frame the shot here. This is the monastery number one that we are entering. A lot of it has been restored. You can clearly understand by the clean cut stones. But these are old structures, and these, oh my god, just wonderful. Let me pump up the ISO. And you enter the complex, and you get to see these. Yes. Yep. No, no. हम जल्दी खा के भाग के आ गए. This is much better. This is great. This is too good. Too good. For me to try my best to get it properly. And you have this one. Just what I'm seeing. I think these are smaller rooms. Smaller rooms. Another section, I don't know the name. Another section, not mentioned properly. Different poses are taken, shooting towards this. Good view from here, so you get a fantastic panoramic view from here. Monastery number 2, monastery number 1, shrine complex, the mother complex, and now we head towards Mahastupa. You can see a lot of the stone pieces have fallen on the ground out here. Let's take a round of the main stupa. Light is beautiful from this side. So let me take a couple of shots of the stupa from here. It's full of shit out here. I mean, not the place, but real human shit. I have no idea why people do this. Simply make this place dirty. This is the Mahakala temple. The stupa out there, Mahakala temple. Mahakala temple, 16th century, so obviously this is much newer. I mean, 16th century is old, but in terms of the other relics and structures around this place, this is a newer one. Let's take a walk around, and we have some more of these pieces out here. I think this was reconstructed because it's all numbered. You can see the number and the sealant in between. Your temple, when there was the deity, the water would come collect. People would collect that as a blessing. Blessed water kind of thing. It's the end. Anything else? No. The odd man out, single wing monastery separate from the rest of the set of. So you don't get to see anything much, just the base structure, but still, what matters is you have it restored. So we have finally come to Udaygiri. It's around 5:45, so it's quite dark, but it's good that we finally managed to come. I'm huffing puffing because I had to run all the way. We have around 15 minutes out here. We'll try. It's very dark, but still we are trying to at least see something. I know it's stupidity, but it's better to see something than nothing.
यू टाइप का सो दैट दिस गिरी नेम इज उदयगिरी यू टाइप के लिए उदयगिरी जी
सो वी हैव कम समवेयर बिटवीन भुवनेश्वर एंड कटक वेयर दे मे अपेरेंटली दे मे गुड रसगुल्लास
मूव ओवर बायस 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 डोंट ट्रस्ट अ बंगाली वर्जन ऑफ रसगुल्ला
दे टीचिंग अस रसगुल्लास Rasgullas! Shit, man! This is called Rasgullas! So we have come here anyway. It's a two different thing. Let's be honest, it's a two different thing. So we'll try it out. Chanar Gaja. There's a Chanar Gaja, Chena Poro, Rasgulla, all these things. ये रसगुल्ला बन रहा है लेकिन ये छेना है पूरा पूरा छेना है putting in the sugar sugar syrup solution It's the chena which they have put in the cloth to take out the excess of water.
He's boiling it in something and putting it in the
Boiling it in sugar syrup.
No, yeah, I know.
No, he's boiling it in sugar syrup. That is sugar syrup.
Yeah, sugar.
So these are chana gaja, these are the rasagulla, and trust me, they taste really different. You can't compare them to because it's very different. And we have the chena poro out here. This is the baked version and that is the steamed version. I had the baked version because that's the one which I like, and these are the rasgullas and the chana gaja, which I have already told you that is there. So you can see there are multiple shops out here, all around the shops, so the carts. This is like a Shoktigarh that you have where you for Langcha, the buses stop and they pick up. So it's the same thing, it's more or less the same taste, but it's different. Trust me, you cannot compare the Bengal rasgullas to here because the basic funda as to the consistency and the softness is very different. So I'm signing off by saying that east or west, Bengali rasgulla is the best. Bye.